morning for the few that are in here. If you'd like to stand with us this morning as we get started.
One thing I'm asking, one thing I'm needing, a moment that's passing is not what I'm seeking. Like it's the air I'm breathing, I want your presence, feet on the earth, heart full of heaven, feel for you, completely consumes me. I can't get enough, can't get enough of you. You're fire burning right through me. I can't get enough of you. You can't get enough of you. You, I'm after your spirit more than a feeling. I don't need a reason, no, to keep chasing who you are. Like it's the air I'm breathing, I want your presence, feet on the earth, heart full of heaven, feel for you, completely consumes me. I can't get enough, can't get enough of you. Your fire burning right through me. I can't get enough, can't get enough of you. Like only you can. Every beat is yours, you can have it all. Take over like only you can. All I'm reaching for, you and nothing more. Take over like only you can. Your fire burning right through me. I can't get enough, can't get enough of you. For you, completely consumes me. I can't get enough, can't get enough of you. Your fire burning right through me. I can't get enough, can't get enough of you. When night has fallen, when fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. I've decided I'm not good. You won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Echo in my soul. Never. every season, you keep repeating promises to me. Now there's no stopping what you have started until it is complete. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. I decided I'm not giving up. You won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is so enough and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is so denied and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo, an echo in my soul. I've decided I'm not giving up. Cause you won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it right now like an echo. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Echo in my soul. As we wait, seek your face. Come and make your throne upon our praise. Here in this place, have your way. The moment that we see you, we are changed. Show us your glory, show us your glory. In wonder and surrender we fall down. Show us your glory, show us your glory. Let every burning heart be holy ground. And holy ground. We're here not by power, not by might, but only by the cross we come alive. We're here, we're undone, overcome by heaven's love revealed before our eyes. Show us your glory, show us your glory. In wonder and surrender we fall down. Show us your glory, show us your glory. Let every burning heart be holy ground. Holy ground. fall, fear, bow here, now. Jesus, you change everything. Lives healed, hope found here, now. Jesus, you change everything. Change. Oh, here, bow, here, now. Jesus, you change everything. Life, heal, hope, bow, here, now. Jesus, you change everything. Everything, lives healed, hope found here now. Jesus, you change everything. Chains fall, fear bow here now. Jesus, you change everything. Lives healed, hope found here now. Jesus, you change everything. Jesus, you change everything. We give it all to you. We give you everything. We give you everything. We give it all to you. We give you everything. We give you everything. Cause all we have is yours. All we have is yours. So come and take it all. Come and take it all. All we have is yours. All we have is yours. So come and take it all. Come and take it all. Is crowned with glory now. The Savior now to wash our feet. Now at His feet we bow. The one who wore our sin and shame, now robed in the radiance of perfect love, now shines for all to see. And your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. And your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. The fear that held us now gives way to Him who is our peace. His final breath upon the cross is now alive in me. Is now alive in me. And your name is victory. All praise will rise. Christ our King, and your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. By your Spirit I will rise from the ashes of defeat. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. By your Spirit I will rise from the ashes of defeat. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. He's resurrecting me. The tomb where soldiers watched in vain was borrowed for 3 days. His body there would not remain. For our God has robbed the grave. Our God has robbed the grave. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King.
By your Spirit, just the drum, sing it out.
By your Spirit, I will rise from the ashes of defeat. The resurrecting King is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrecting King is resurrecting me. By your Spirit, I will rise from the ashes of defeat. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. You're resurrecting me. Oh, I was dead. My sin took a hold of me. You breathed your life. Now you're resurrecting me. I was dead. My sin took a hold of me. You breathed your life. Now you are resurrecting me. Now you are resurrecting me. I was dead. My sin took a hold of me. You breathed your life. Now you're resurrecting.
see me. I was dead. My sin took a hold of me. You breathed your life. Now you're resurrecting me. I was dead. My sin took a hold of me. You breathed your life. Now you're resurrecting me. I was dead. My sin took a hold of me. You breathed your life. Now you're resurrecting me. I was dead. My sin took a hold of me. You breathed your life. Now you're resurrecting me. Now you're resurrecting me. I was dead. My sin took a hold of me. You breathed your life. Now you're resurrecting me. I was dead. My sin took a hold of me. You breathed your life. Now you're resurrecting me. Now you're resurrecting me.
Just worship him this morning. I feel like there's a breakthrough that needs to happen in this place this morning. There's been a wall built up, and the praises aren't making it through. So this morning, I want you to sing these words. With victory in your heart and victory in your spirit. And we're going to break through some walls this morning. And let the devil know that even though last week was Easter Sunday, Jesus is still alive this Sunday. Amen. That grave is still empty in this place. For our God is alive.
And your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King.
Sing it again.
Your name is victory. All praise will rise.
Never gonna let me
me down. For that breakthrough.
You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down.
Sing it out.
You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down.
Let me hear you.
You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down.
I can't hear you this morning, come on.
You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down.
Sing it!
You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down.
No!
You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down. You are good, good.
I feel like we're right on that edge of breakthrough. We're right there, just a little bit longer. Who here wants the Spirit to flow in this place? Amen? He can't flow if you don't praise. So we gotta praise Him with everything. I don't care if you look around, there's not as many people as last week. The Spirit still shows up, there's people here. But three or more are gathered, He shows up, amen? So we're going to keep worshiping and let Him know that His presence is welcome in this place. Amen. Because He is worthy. You are so worthy, Lord. And You are welcome here in this place. We want Your presence in this place. We need Your glory in this place, Lord. So heaven, come down and meet us here. Heaven, come down and meet us here. Just cry out. Cry out with your voice. and adoration and worship. Let him know he's welcome here this morning. If I can't hear you, he can't hear you. Come on. I know you know how to scream. You've done it before. Cry out.
You're here with me.
Let that sink into your spirit this morning.
I used to think that I could box you in, but you're here with me. I'm laying down all my religion. I'm laying down. I want to know you, Lord. I'm laying down all my religion. I'm laying down. I want to know you. I want to know you, Lord. Lord, I've been told to be ashamed. All I've been told, I don't measure up. All I've been told, I'm not good enough. But you're here with me. All I've been told, to be ashamed. All I've been told, I don't measure up. All I've been told, I'm not good enough, but you're here with me. I reach out and you find me in the dust. They say no amount of untruths can separate us. I reach out and you find me. This ain't no amount of untruths can separate us.
This love is so deep.
It's more than I can stand. I'm melting your peace. It's overwhelming. I wanna sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe, feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I'm melting your peace, it's overwhelming.
If you're able this morning, I just want you to find a place in reverence, whether that's on your knees or sitting down. I'm just going to sing this out again. Just have this intimate moment with God right now. Just pour our love on Him.
The more I seek you, the more I find you. The more I find you, the more I love you, the more I seek. The more I seek you, the more I find you. The more I find you, the more I love you.
I feel like as we're worshiping that the Lord wants us to continue in what we're doing right now. I feel like you guys see all these empty seats. This is what the devil does. We have a huge event, and you guys know in the history of this church. Then the next week, even most of our regulars aren't even here. And so the thing is, the devil uses this to distract and to discourage, especially those of you in this room who invited people here. So we're going to go ahead and let Daniel go because he has to go to the kids' church. But you know what? We're going to do announcements and we're going to do offering at the end. And I'm going to move my message to next week because as we're sitting here, I feel like the Lord is saying, what a distraction the devil will bring. And we are a praying people. And so I'm going to have Jason, he's going to hand out the index cards or whatever we have over there that you can write on. And here's what we're going to do. And we're still going to have prayer tonight. But I don't want to interrupt this worship time. And we're going to go into a heavy prayer time. Are you guys with me this morning? Can you track with this? Because I feel like we have enough of our regulars that you guys are here that it will not offend you if we move the message to next week. And so right now, we are going to go into a time of serious prayer. And so what I'm going to have you do is, Jason is going to hand out the index cards. And what I want you to do, while Matthew continues singing for a moment, I want you to take a pen and I want you to write on that index card everyone you invited to Easter last week. Put their names on it that showed up. Write down those you've invited to this church ever since you've been attending. And they have come once, but they have not come back. And then those of you that have been here for a while, write down the names of those you know came to this church and got radically saved. And they were on fire for at least a year or more. And now they have fallen off a cliff and they have floundered off. You see these seats? We're going to pray again tonight for these seats. But this morning, make this list. And I want you, one at a time, you can come up to the mic. once you get your list going and everything, we are just going to cry out for the salvation of every person you put on that list. Also, it doesn't have to be someone you've invited. Although, if you have invited people to church and they have not shown up, put their name on the list. If they live in this area and there's no reason they couldn't be here, they could drive, they're close enough. Also, if you have family members that are unsaved, you have children that are unsaved, write them down. Today, we're all going to intercede for those. You're going to intercede for those on that list, and you're going to call them out by name as Matthew continues to lead us in prayer worship. And you are going to speak out. I want you to make your way around if you need to. Find an empty row. And you call out those names and you prophesy over those people in your life that you want to see saved, delivered, and set free. You've invited them to this building. They've come. They have not come back. Or people here that are dear to your heart that have not been attending for the last few months for whatever reason. We have to pray them in, you guys. We have to pray them back here. There is an Easter harvest. This building was full last week. We had about 210 people here. Here's the thing. This has always happened every year. The next Sunday, those of you that have been with us for a while, you know the next Sunday it's empty. It's a scheme of the devil. He wants us to feel like our prayers and our work means nothing. And that's a lie. And so while we were worshiping, he said, I want you guys to pray in the harvest this morning. Move your message to next week. But those that did not come back, pray in those souls back to this building. That those that came last week, that received, you can't enter this building without receiving, you guys, because the glory's here. That whatever they received, they took it home, and it's ruminating. And it's preparing to plant the marvelous seed that God has for them in their life. And that they will come back to this building in some form. And they will become solid men and women of God serving the King of Kings. And so as Matthew leads us, make that list. If you know them in your head, that's great. But you're going to prophesy over each person on your list. And if you want to walk around and do it, you want privacy, that's fine. Make your way around the building. Go wherever you want. And you speak life over each one of those names. And you believe salvation for them. You believe that every word you've spoken, every encouragement, every invite to this building will not fall on deaf ears. You guys, it has not fallen on deaf ears. And I know this is discouraging, especially for those of you that invited people last week. And they're not here this week. It can be discouraging, and it can be disruptive in your heart and make you think that it's not working. And so what I'm here to tell you, do you know what these empty seats represent? These empty seats represent prayers we're supposed to be praying. God uses everything for His glory and our good. So we're going to intercede for every person. Anyone you met last week at this service, intercede for them. Pray for their salvation. Pray that their family comes back, that they get radically saved and set on fire for God. Pray for your family members that you have invited here. So we're going to pray, and I want you guys to just worship and just pray and just believe God to intercede for everyone on your list, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and lead out, and I'm going to give you guys permission, but you have to stick to the subject, to come up during the prayer time, and you are welcome to come and pray in the mic the names of your people, and we will agree with you. That way we can agree with you, and we can be on board with prophesying over those people. And so, are you guys ready? Sorry that there's not going to be a coffee break till after. Okay, so let's go ahead and if you guys will, stand up, let's wake up a little bit. Stand up if you can. We're going to have Matt lead us for a moment, and then you guys can find your places to pray. I want you to repeat this after me. I will not be discouraged. My prayers are heard, and God is answering them in Jesus' name. Okay, let's worship for a moment, and then we're going to go into a time of intercession.
The ground began to shake. The stone was rolled away. His perfect love cannot be overcome. Now death, where is your sting? Our resurrected King has rendered you defeated forever. He is glorified. Ground began to shake. The storm was rolled away. His perfect love could not be overcome. Now death, where is your sting? Our resurrected King has rendered you defeated forever.
Continues to sing and lead us in worship. Please make your way around to pray for those on your card, those on Facebook Live. If you did not hear the instructions, please enter into a time of prayer in your home or wherever you are at. Make a list and pray for those. If you were normally here, that you invite to this building and they have come, but they have not come back. They have not come to fill the seat that has been prophesied for them to fill. So those of you on Facebook, you join in with us. And we're going to pray for the Easter harvest. We're going to pray for every soul that came last week. We're going to pray for every family member, for you. And we're going to all agree together. And we're going to intercede for souls this morning. And we're going to make this a time of intercession. So please pray with us. Pray with us. Pray with us.
There's a grace when the heart is under fire. Another way when the walls are closing in. And when I fall in the space between where I used to be in this reckoning, I know I will never be alone. There was another in the fire standing next to me. There was another in the waters holding back the seas. And should I ever need reminding of how I've been set free, there is a cross that bears the burden where another died for me. There was another in the fire. There was another in the fire. All my sin left the dead beneath the waters. I'm no longer a slave to my sin anymore. And if I fall in the space between what remains of me and this reckoning, either way I won't bow to the things of this world. And I know I will never be alone. There is another in the fire standing next to me. There is another in the waters holding back the seas. And should I ever need reminding what power set me free, there is a grave that holds nobody. Now the power lives in me. There is another in the fire. Oh, 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 I can see the light in the darkness. As the darkness bows to him, I can hear the roar in the heavens. As the space between within, I can feel the ground shake beneath us. As the prison walls cave in, nothing stands between us. Nothing stands between us. Another in the fire standing next to me. There'll be another in the waters holding back the seas. And should I ever need reminding how good you've been to me, I'll count the joy from every
battle, cause I know that's where you'll be. There'll be another in the fire, standing next to me. There'll be another in the waters, holding back the seas. And should I ever need reminding how good you've been to me, I'll count the joy from every battle, cause I know that's where you'll be. I'll count the joy from every battle, cause I know that's where you'll be. I'll count the joy from every battle, cause I know that's where you'll be. I'll count the joy from every battle, cause I know that's where you'll be. I'll count the joy from every battle, cause I know that's where you'll be. In every situation, you are there. In every unanswered prayer, you were there. When I need you most, you never let me down. You never let me down. You never let me down. And even if he doesn't, I will praise him. And even if he doesn't, I will stand tall. And even if he doesn't, I will praise him. And even if he doesn't, I will stand tall. And even if he doesn't, I will praise him. And even if he doesn't, I will stand tall. And even if he doesn't, I will praise him. And even if he doesn't, I will stand tall. There'll be another in the fire, standing next to me. There'll be another in the waters, holding back the sea. Should I ever need reminding how good you've been to me? I'll count the joy from every battle, cause I know that's where you'll be. I'll count the joy from every battle, cause I know that's where you'll be. I'll count the joy from every battle, cause I know that's where you'll be.
are the people who call on your name. We look to heaven as we call on your name. So watch you fall on every tribe, bone, and place. Send the rain. We are the people who will call on your name. We look to heaven as we call on your name. So watch you fall on every tribe, bone, and place. Send the rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. So watch you fall on every dry bone and place. Send the rain. We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. So won't you fall on every dry bone and place. Send the rain.
In this harvest,
we are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. So won't you fall on every dry bone and place. Send the rain. We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. So won't you fall on every tribe, bone, and place. Send the rain. We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. So won't you fall on every tribe, bone, and place. Send the rain, 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 send the rain. The people who will call on your rain. people who will call on your ring. We look to heaven as we call on your ring. So won't you fall on every dry bone and place?
The Lord just told me that He is very pleased. He is very pleased. He needs us to press in. You have to believe for the rain over your family. You have to believe for the rain over your unsaved loved ones, your unsaved friends, those families that are not here, that are floundering. He is pleased with this prayer time. He is pleased with each of you pressing in. So press in, press in. Call for the rain. Call for the rain over your families. Call for the rain over your unsaved friends and loved ones. Prophesy it. Prophesy for the rain to come. Press in this morning. Press in this morning.
We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. So won't you fall on every dry bone and place? Sing the rain, sing the rain. We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. So won't you fall on every dry bone and place? Sing the rain. We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven and we call on your rain. So won't you fall on every dry bone and place? Sing the rain. We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. So won't you fall on every dry bone and face? Sing the rain, sing the rain. Sing the rain, sing the rain. Sing the rain, 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 sing the rain. Fall on every dry bone and place. Sing the rain, sing the rain. We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. Won't you find every dry bone and place? Sin rain. We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. Won't you fall on every dry bone and place? Sin rain. We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. Won't you fall on every dry bone and place? Sin rain.
I need to take about 5 minutes, and I want you to just pray in the Spirit. Just in the Spirit, because some of you have been already, but the devil cannot interfere, nor does he know what's being prayed for. Pray in the Spirit for those family members that come to your mind, to those friends, those unsaved friends that come to your mind. Pray in the Spirit. If you're baptized in the Holy Spirit, pray in your prayer language. Pray in your prayer language for the next 5 minutes, and just intercede in the Spirit for your loved ones, for your unsaved children, for your unsaved family members, for your unsaved loved ones, your unsaved co-workers. Let's intercede now, right now.
We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. Won't you fall on every dry bone and place? Sing the rain. We are the people who will call on your rain. We look to heaven as we call on your rain. Won't you fall on every dry bone and place? Sing the rain. There's nothing I want more. There's nothing I want more. More of you, Jesus. Declare his name. There's nothing I want more. There's nothing I want more. More of you, Jesus. There's nothing I want more. There's nothing I want more. More of you, Jesus. There's nothing I want more. There's nothing I want more. More of you, Jesus. There's nothing I nothing I want more. More of you, Jesus. There's nothing I want more. There's nothing I want more. More of you, Jesus. So set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. So set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more, 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 I want more of you. So pour it out. I want more, 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 I want more of you. So pour it out. No place I would rather be. There's no place I would rather be. There's no place I would rather be than hearing your love. Hearing your love, there's no place I would rather be. There's no place I would rather be. There's no place I would rather be than hearing your love, hearing your love. So set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. So set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. I want more of you. Nothing I want more. There's nothing I want more. More of you, Jesus. There's nothing I want more. There's nothing I want more. More of you, Jesus. Of my enemies, I raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me, and I raise a hallelujah. My weapon is melody, and I raise a hallelujah. Sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder. Sing a little louder. In the presence of my enemies, I sing a little louder. My weapon is a melody. I sing a little louder. In the presence
let's
of
raise a hallelujah in this place.
Sing a little louder.
Raise a hallelujah against my every block that would try to stop your family members
sing
from getting saved.
Louder.
Everybody stand up that can. You can stand up. We're going to raise a hallelujah.
Louder.
We're going to raise a hallelujah against every lie of the enemy. We're going to raise a hallelujah against every scheme that he's plotted to keep your friends and family from entering this building. We're going to raise a hallelujah. We're going to raise a hallelujah against every scheme and every lie and every block and every hindrance. So I want you to sing it. I want you to sing it loud and proud. Raise a hallelujah in this place. We raise a hallelujah. We raise a hallelujah.
Hallelujah. In the presence of my enemies, I raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me, and I raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody. Sing a little louder. Sing a little louder. Sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder. Sing a little louder. In the presence of my enemies, sing a little louder. My weapon is a melody. Sing a little louder. In the presence of my enemies, sing a little louder. Sing a little louder. And I raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemies. Raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me. I raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody.
I just want to tell you the story really quickly, and then we're going to sing this again. We've sung it enough. You know the words. There's no excuse. Sorry, I'm being in your face. There is no excuse, once you know the words, to not raise a hallelujah. Let me tell you the story behind how this song got written. There was a young little man, a little baby, a toddler, 18 months, 19 months, 2 years old. Bethel Church, when they wrote this song, the song came about because that church, as huge as they are, with all their music and their books and their things that they do and the things we've taught here, this is their song. As huge as they are not so huge that when one of the people in their church, their little son, went into the hospital sick and they didn't think he was going to live. And one of the worship leaders got the call. The whole church came together. They said that he wasn't going to make it. He wasn't barely 2 years old. They said he's really sick. They say he's going to die. He's probably not going to make it through the night. Here's this two-year-old baby. The church comes together and they intercede for this baby. And after all the prayers, one of the worship leaders, the one that wrote this song, he calls and he says to the parents, to the dad, what are we looking at? What are we looking at? Because we've been praying. And the dad said, he's not going to make it. They said he won't make it through the night. He's going to pass away. And this worship leader, he crumbled and he fell to the floor. And he said, what do we got? What do we got? But to raise a hallelujah. All we got is to raise a hallelujah. And he began to sing. The song is our weapon. The melody is all he had because he was a worship leader. So he began to sing, 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 sing. And he said he felt like this huge wall came up. And it was a giant. And it was death. And it was staring their church in the face. And it was going to take this baby boy. And he said, I had nothing. All I had was my praise and my hallelujah. So he sat down in his devastation and his pain and suffering for his close friend at the loss of their baby. And he wrote this song. He wrote this song. And he rose a hallelujah. So here's the thing. Now that you know the story behind how this song came to be, he wrote this song as he faced the giant of death that was going to take this little boy, his close friend's little boy. And he just began to sing. So we're going to sing this again. We're going to sing this again. We don't need powerful drums. We don't need it to be all loud and proud. We need to be loud and proud. So we're going to sing this, raise a hallelujah again. Whatever your giant is that you have been facing, whatever has been hindering all the work you feel like you've been doing, I feel like that's what's on the Father's heart this morning. All of us have been working. We have been working. We have tirelessly come every week and set up and tear down and minister and have events and reach out and love people and invite them. They come for a couple of weeks, but it's just not their moment, you guys. It's not their time. But we can pray them in. We can pray them back in the building. We can pray in our unsaved children. We can pray in our unsaved friends. We can raise a hallelujah against the giant that has tried to block your prayers, that has tried to block what you've been trying to do, what God's been trying to use you for. Here's the thing. We know more than anyone, me and my husband. Empty seats are not fun. But we know the devil's game. And he will not win. And so this morning as I sat here in worship, I was like, you know what, devil? You're not winning today. We're going to intercede for souls for the Easter harvest. And we're going to believe that they will come back. They will be here. And that all of our work is not for anything. All of our watchman prayer has not been for nothing. But see, the devil will allow this, the empty seats, to make you think, what's the point? Why try? Why try? Nobody's hearing you. Nobody's listening. Nobody cares. Nobody wants this Jesus that you're walking around on fire with. So here's the thing. I'm like, you ain't winning today, devil. We're going to pray. Because you know what? Prayer and praise is our weapon. So let's raise another hallelujah. And I want to hear you guys this time. You're going to raise it like that giant is coming down. That giant in front of you is coming down. Let's raise a hallelujah in this place.
I'll raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemies. I'll raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I'll raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody. I raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me. And I'm gonna stay in the middle of the storm. Louder and louder, you're gonna hear my praises roar. Up from the ashes, hope will arise. Death is defeated, the King is alive. I raise a hallelujah with everything inside of me. I raise a hallelujah. I will watch the darkness flee. I raise a hallelujah in the middle of the mystery. I raise a hallelujah. Fear you lost your hold on me. And I gotta stay in the middle of the storm. Louder and louder, you're gonna hear my praises roar. Hope will arise. Death is defeated. Our King is alive. Sing a little louder. 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 Sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder.
You sing that. Sing a little louder in the presence of my enemies. Sing a little louder. My weapon is a melody. Sing a little louder.
in the presence of my enemies.
Jesus, we raise a hallelujah in this place. You guys, there is no giant too big for God. Whatever it is, there is no giant. Imagine this. Imagine getting a call or making the call and hearing that the baby's dying. They've done said it. It's done. There's no hope. Who can agree? That's like a huge giant. Death is a huge giant. But they kept praying and they kept believing. And that baby lived. That baby lived. And guess what? They wrote a song about him. This song that blesses us because of what God did in his life by saving him. And if you watch the original, when they first announced the song, the song and the testimony of it. You got to find it. It's a different video on YouTube. They showed almost through the whole thing, the baby on the dad's shoulders, bouncing around and praising Jesus. What an amazing sight. There is nothing the Lord can't do, you guys. Nothing. Saving your children and your unsaved loved ones and your friends, that ain't hard for him. He just needs you not to give up. And I really felt like, think of this. Not that I'm ever thankful for empty chairs, but God always seems to allow me to use them to work for our good, for a lesson. If it hadn't been for these empty chairs, we would have not have interceded this morning. We would have went on as business as usual. But I believe that God was saying that there were people who needed us to pray for them this morning. And they got their prayers that they needed. There are people that were here last week that went home and they're in a battle this week. Maybe they're at home and their wife or their husband doesn't want to come back. Maybe something bad happened. One of their kids are hurt. I mean, we don't know. We don't know by interceding this morning what difference we just made in the lives of every person that has come. I'm saying in the history of this church, there's a lot of ringing. Okay. Okay. Is that any better? But you know, we don't know what our intercession did this morning. We don't know how it could have broke open something for the families that showed up last week. And I'm not talking about just last Easter. I'm talking about every Easter. There's a harvest from every Easter. We had like 500 people here the year before. We've got to keep praying for every bit of harvest. And every family, there's those of you here, you know families that used to attend faithfully. And they decided they're too busy for church. There's no good reason why they're not here. Nobody offended them. They're not unhappy with people or they're not getting along with anyone. It's not like that. And I've heard them say to me, I don't have any good reason for not being in church. I've just been busy. Well, it's pretty scary when you get busy for months. Because, man, you get so far away. We all know that, right? But here's the thing. Don't let your efforts cause you to feel far away. Because whatever you say, the seeds that you plant to those people that you have invited, that you have tried to pour into and to love, It is working. Eventually, it's going to work, you guys. Your prayers. This prayer this morning. And then Jason got this word while he was praying. A vision and a word. At first, I saw clouds heavy with rain building up with a heavy downpour. A downpour is coming. I then saw a flower bed with blooming flowers. But instead of flowers, they were babies. These are the harvest we are praying for, and we'll start to see streaming in as we continue to obey by praying for the rain and for the harvest. We are being set up to become a maternity ward nursery for souls. So here's the thing. For those of you that don't know, When we went to Contend America last July, we went to Colorado, and we went, they had a big, huge prayer summit where hundreds of people came together, and we fasted and prayed for a week. And some of our church members went with us, and our church staff, we all went. Thursday, which we started, everything started on Monday. By Thursday, one of the intercessors there came up and spoke a word to me. She said, I have a word for you, and I'm not going to say the whole word now. But in the word, she said, she didn't even know I was a pastor. She knew nothing about me. We had not met the whole week. She said that you are a mother. God has created you to be a mother to many, but many more are coming. And he's preparing you because there's more coming. And so the thing is, there are more coming. It doesn't look like it sometimes. And it can be discouraging. But there are more coming. And you know what? Prayer is the foundation of this church. So please, if you ever come and it happens to where the Spirit moves and we end up doing an intercession time, please don't get offended. Because prayer is priority in this church. If God says you're going to take this opportunity and you're going to intercede for the empty chairs, although we didn't do that, we're doing that tonight. So if you come back at 6:30, we're going to be interceding and we're going to prophesy over each one of these chairs that they're going to be filled with whoever God's called to be filling them. And so that was already planned for tonight. But this morning, he wanted us to just intercede and raise a hallelujah for those who you have invited, and even those of you that are connected with those that have been here since the history of the church. We can't forget about the people floundering, you guys. We can't just forget. I mean, we can never forget. It's our job and our calling to continue to work and to pray and to believe and not get discouraged. I'm telling you, it's very easy. We could get discouraged. Pastors get discouraged all the time. We want to see souls saved, and we want them to have what we have and what you guys have that are faithful, so that once they get it, they can't live without it. The same way when you come to church, you got to be here, or you got to be wherever, you know. The fire. We want them to have that. But until then, we have to pray them in and not forget about them. And so I want you guys to know that, and thank you, Jason, for this word. It goes right along with a lot of the things that have been prophesied over this church. And I know it's hard when you don't see it yet. But there has been prophecies over this church that this gym would be so full of people that people were lined up out to the desert to get into this building. It was prophesied over this building, over this church. It was prophesied that the Holy Ghost was going to move so powerfully. We've already seen it here, y'all. You think you've seen it? You ain't seen nothing yet. And the Lord woke me up early one morning and he spoke this word to me. Basically, you haven't seen anything yet. When it truly hits, it will blow your mind. I will blow your mind. My mind hasn't been blown yet. So we got work to do, y'all. Because he's coming and he's going to blow some minds. And it was prophesied that there's a land and a building coming. I don't know how that's showing up. I don't know where the money's coming from, but God knows. But what he's asked us to do is to be faithful. So I'm going to have Zach go ahead and come up and receive the tithes and offering. And I want you guys to know I am so thankful that you hung out and you agreed to pray and to intercede. And I'll tell you, when you leave today, if you see any slightest bit of progress, we want to know about it for anybody you prayed for. You let us know. You tell us. You tell us. You tell us any praise reports. And I'm going to hand it over to Zach. And then we will go through some announcements because there's some important stuff coming up. And so we do have to have Angela do announcements. So.
All right. We're going to finally get ready to give this morning. The ushers want to come forward. We're just going to jump right into it this morning, not make it anything long or special. You guys all know why we give. You guys know what it's for and why it's important for not only for ourselves but for the church. So we're just going to pray and go right into giving this morning. Amen. Dear God, thank you so much for this time just to jump right back into giving to you, God. We love giving to you, God, and we thank you for giving us the opportunity to give to you, God, with our finances and the jobs that you've provided for us, God. God, we praise you and we thank you for this time, God, that we've come together just to worship you, God, and just to raise our hallelujah, God, and praise you in the midst of everything, Jesus. And God, we pray that in the midst of everything, whether it's a hard time or a good time, God, that we would just always remember to be faithful and give back to your kingdom, God. In your name we pray. Amen.
Good morning. Okay. Good morning, Facebook Live. I hope you all are still with us this morning. So we have a lot of announcements that are happening, and I know that I'm standing up here every single Sunday, but I really need you guys to listen to what the announcements are and what's happening, because there's a lot happening in the church. And we really need everybody to start getting involved and being a part of this church more, okay? I don't really like listening to myself talk all the time. So, listen. The story of marriage is coming for the Connect Group on Wednesday. If you haven't signed up, I really encourage you to sign up. You don't have to be married to do this class. In fact, I really encourage those who are single to do this class. It's really going to help you for your future relationships. And if you've been in Beta Satan with me and Kevin, it was very interesting, and I can guarantee you the marriage will be even more interesting. So come join us. Love you, honey. we have that starting this Wednesday at 6:45 here on campus. We have childcare, we have youth group, and we have kids group. So please come. If you have not signed up, please sign up at the Resource Center, because we need to know how many chairs and how many tables and how to set up, because it's right here in the music room, but we have to set it up. So we really need you guys to sign up for that, okay? And Pastor Liberty is actually leading the class. So, you know, it'll be a very interesting class, okay? May 19th, Raised to Life Baptism is happening. So if you would like to get baptized and you would like some more information on baptism, please see Pastor Liberty. But there is a sign-up sheet and back there for the Resource Center. And there's also a form for you to fill out that's right next to it. So if you would like to get baptized, again, that's May 19th. Restoration Freedom Conference is June 22nd here on campus at 9:30 in the morning. If you have never done the restoration, I really, really encourage you to do the restoration. It's really going to help you in your next steps of where you're going to fall into the church, where you're going to fall for yourself in your walk with Christ, everything. It's a really amazing thing to go through. So I really encourage that. Mother's Day, May 12th, 10 a.m. Special speaker is Rami Lukes. She has a special message just for us. We're also going to be having a banquet breakfast for all the mothers, and all the dads and the men in the church are going to be cooking for us, y'all. So I'm looking forward to that. Don't be shaking your head no. You'll be cooking. So, so you know, you guys come and check that out. We also are giving away Mother's Day awards, and I can tell you firsthand, they're pretty awesome this year. Okay, so come out for that and invite
it's
mothers. You know, anybody you know. Okay,
we get an iPad.
What?
The prize is an iPad. Just everyone else.
Then we have Father's Day coming up, Sunday, June 16th. The speaker is Lane Blair, a retired pastor out of Abundant Grace Church in Lake Havasu City. And the women will be serving breakfast to the men. So, you know, what goes around comes around, all right, y'all? Okay, so come and join us. Bring the fathers for that too, all right? Again, youth and kids camp. If you are still have not signed your kids up and you're still in need of some help, let us know. We will figure out what to do. We're going to find a way. We're working on fundraisers. Pastor Zach and Becca and Pastor Daniel, they're working on fundraisers right now for those that still need help. So we will get your kids to camp. Again, it's the youth camp is June 23rd to the 27th. The cost is $275. The kids camp is July 8th through the 11th, and the cost is $225. We also have coming up for the on June 29th and July 20th, we are doing summer movie nights here in campus in the gym. So it'll be nice and air conditioned. We'll have the screen up. We're going to do popcorn and all kinds of stuff. So those of you that, especially like Chandelier and stuff like that, you guys, youth, get the youth involved. Have them come down for these. These are pretty cool, okay? And it's really nice, especially for the summer. Get the family involved. Something free and something nice to do. It's going to keep them all air conditioned, all right? So let's do that. Also, we have next class coming. The next class is going to be May 5th and the 19th. So if you are wondering what the next step for you is in the church and how you can volunteer and what you can do and where you're being called, what God's calling you to do in the church, I encourage you to do the next classes. They're also, the sign-up sheets are in the back for that also, okay, at the Resource Center. Okay, also, the new believers. If you are new and you're going, I don't know what's going on, I'm just showing up, I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to do or how this goes about, I encourage you to do the new believers class. We don't have a date for it yet, but we do have a sign up in the back. So the more people we get to sign up for the new believers class, then we'll be able to get a date for that. So I encourage you, if you're just kind of strolling in but not really sure what's happening, I definitely encourage you to do the new believers class, okay? Shirts are in. If you have pre-ordered a shirt, they are in the back, but you have to pay for it first before you can get it, okay? We also have a couple shirts left over, but it's, you know, first come, first serve. Get it while it's hot type thing, because there's not very many of them left, okay? And they're $12. So I will be in the back after church so you guys can get your shirts, okay? And happy Sunday, everybody.
Amen. Sorry. So just, you know, definitely with the marriage class, please sign up. You don't have to be married to do that. Single people, if you plan on ever being in another relationship, then you would want to do that. And he's all no. Ignore the peanut gallery behind me. Okay. Please sign up to do this group. I'm telling you, it's going to be awesome. Each week, I'm going to walk you through the story of marriage, and I also will have some stories of my own that I will be sharing. You'll get to hear juicy information, juicy stories you've never heard before, but you have to be here. Also, you can sign up for that here, but also those of you on Facebook Live, you can reply to the church network and confirm, and we will sign you up. But I need to know for material, if I want to print out questions, discussion guides, or anything like that, I need to know a kind of an idea of a head count. We don't want to waste printing out a bunch of stuff for people that aren't there. But I recommend, if you have not done any kind of marriage conferences, marriage classes, or groups, come do this, because it is so good. There's those in this room that did it the first time we did it. We did it once. We did it as an actual conference, not as a group class. And it is so good. John and Lisa Bevere are so real and candid. They admit, they have juicy stories of their own. They tell it like it is, and they're real. So get here for that group, and that is starting this Wednesday. Also, it starts at 6:45, but the first 15 minutes, we do worship and all that stuff. We officially probably get started about 7:10. So we ask, because there is a video with each one, that you be here by 7 o'clock, because it's disruptive if you come in after the video has started. And most likely, the video will start at 7:10. So please be here. Also, you don't want to miss worship. We always open with Matt plays live with the guitar. and he leads us in one song and prepares our hearts for group. So try to be here by 6:45 if you can for that. And please sign up. What I've noticed is by the end of our services, everybody's so full of the glory that they leave and they don't sign up for nothing. And then they reply to the church network and say, me, me, me. But they forgot because they leave all drunk in the spirit and they're like, what? I didn't sign up. I'm supposed to. Okay. So then you forget by the end of service. So sign up for that. And I believe there was a couple other things other than the raised to life baptism. Even if you have, and I just wanted to mention on that, if you have been baptized but you were a child and you kind of did your own thing and you rededicated your life in recent years and you want to get rebaptized, that's not weird. You can be rebaptized. And it doesn't mean you're saying the first baptism didn't count. No. But maybe you're at a different place in your life that you have a better understanding of truly walking with Christ and having your profession of faith. So sign up for it. Also, our goal is by the next baptism is to finally have our shirts. Our heart is for every person that gets baptized to have a shirt that says raised to life. And you're going to wear that when you're baptized. And so our heart, but we have to buy those in bulk also to get the price that we need. So, you know, it's a little work in progress because we're a small church. So, but you guys are awesome. Have a wonderful, wonderful Sunday. Please, if you're able to, come back tonight for prayer, 6:30 to 7:30. We have our prayer time. We are going to pray over these empty seats one by one, and we're going to prophesy, and we're going to anoint them, and we're going to pray over them and believe that God's going to fill these seats. And so let me go ahead and close you in prayer, and then you guys can go ahead and enjoy the rest of your Sunday. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you, Lord, for all that you did today, Lord. We thank you, and it was an honor to come and to intercede and to pray, Lord, for the harvest. Lord, I pray that these prayers that we pray today would not fall on deaf ears, that they would make their way, Lord, into the hearts and the homes of those that were being prayed for, Lord. God, I just speak life into every home of every person that was interceded for today. I pray that your glory would invade those places. I pray, Lord, for each person here that they will not get discouraged and distracted, that they will trust you, that they will keep praying, that they will keep believing for their family members and their friends and their coworkers. Lord, I pray that you give everyone here Holy Ghost gumption to keep praying and keep believing. Lord, we thank you, we praise you, and we honor you. I speak your blessing over every family represented here, every family and every person watching by Facebook Live. We speak a blessing over you. And we thank everybody for your prayers. In Jesus' name, amen.